Welcome to the Four Listeners Program. Welcome aboard, everybody. Thanks for checking us out this week. What up, everybody? I'm Spear, and on the mics for me this week is the Z-Man. What is up, Z?
Out of the sea, wish I could be part of your world.
Okay. All right. I wish you weren't a part of mine right now. On the other mic is the Mike Ganthor. What is up, Ganthor?
Heyo.
Heyo. What's going on, man?
Just got back from a recruiting trip.
A recruiting
trip? To a local state university.
Wow. Trying to drag people into your life of crime?
Yeah. That's a good way to put it.
Excellent. All right. This week, something must be done about art.
Hold on. How are you doing, buddy?
Oh, I'm good, dude. I'm good. I'm moving
been
on.
A while.
I'm a little frustrated, and I'll tell you why, pal.
Yeah.
A couple of weeks ago, I went to the Philadelphia Museum of Art, and it is an absolutely magnificent museum. It covers all kinds of different styles of art, from photography to architecture, painting, sculpture. It has all kinds of different periods of art and architecture. You can go in some of these rooms. You can go and see like a Japanese ceremonial tea house. You can go and see photography. They have an exhibit right now, Wild by Michael Nichols. Absolutely unbelievable stuff of him being out in the jungles of Africa, taking pictures of all kinds of gorillas and elephants and tigers in motion in their natural habitat. Unbelievable stuff. You can go into the Renaissance paintings and see some of the masters of art. You can see Renoir, Cezanne, Monet, Manet, Van Gogh. I mean, they have Van Gogh's sunflowers right there hanging on the wall. I mean, these are artists and paintings that you see in the books, like in the art history books. And there they are right in front of you for you to see. I mean, it's unbelievably amazing stuff.
Is that your first time ever going?
No, but every time I go, I find myself, you know, floored by some of the creations that are in there. And you can absolutely and truly appreciate the artistry in some of these things. And then you go down the hall from where you have these master works of art. And then you enter in a room of an exhibit from a guy named Marcel Duchamp. Marcel Duchamp is a ready-made artist. And what he does is he takes things that exist in the world and he scrawls something on them, maybe signs it, puts it up on a pedestal, and calls it art. As an example, he takes a urinal, a regular, run-of-the-mill, porcelain urinal, scrawls some name or some bullshit on it, calls it fountain, and calls it art. And this urinal is down the hall, 500 steps away from these masters, these masterworks of art, is this fucking urinal. What the fuck is that about? How could that be?
Really angry.
It drives me nuts, Ganthor.
Is it a new urinal or is it used?
It was used.
Like, so there's like streak marks on it?
Well, I didn't get close enough to look to see whether or not he cleaned it first or he sanitized it before he called it art. Or if there was a little blue cake or something in the middle of it. I didn't see it. But he just put a urinal and called it art.
Like calcium buildup or something, you know, and people it leaves marks.
I didn't see whether or not he had hard water. All I know is that he put a urinal on a pedestal, named it fountain, and called it art.
I put your mom on a pedestal and I call it art.
I mean, am
sounds
I
like
the...
a compliment, kind of.
It was a compliment. It was intentional. Mom's a beautiful woman.
Thank you. I appreciate that. That's very nice of you to say after all these years of abusing her. Never mind. Let's just move on. I can't rationalize it in my head.
Is the issue that you have, is it that you have artists that you respect and are classical artists that you respect in the same building as artists that you do not respect? Or is it the issue that you just don't respect that artist?
It's probably more the latter. It's both.
Would you like me to help you smash it up at night wearing ski masks?
Yes. Yes. Me and you, Ganthor. We're going to go in here and we're going to correct a few problems because this isn't the only thing that I found objectionable. Just around the corner from Fountain was another work of art. It was one of those old style telephones. You know, like the
by
old
the, hold on, by the same dude?
No, it's a different dude now. A different dude had an old style telephone. You know, like a rotary phone, an old style rotary phone, like old timey type of thing.
Oh, I love those phones.
Right, and then he put it next to a cow pie. You guys know what a cow pie is?
Piece of shit.
It's a chunk of shit.
Was it really one?
Yes. Yes, it was a dried cow pie, Ganthor. It was sitting right there next to this telephone, and it was under glass, and it was called art. This other guy took a big felt suit, a big gray, big blocky, bulky felt suit, and hung it up on the wall. You know what he called it?
Art.
Felt suit was the name of the exhibit. Called it felt suit, called it art.
Who's this shithead?
I don't have to look it up. But by that definition, I got all kinds of art going on in my fucking closet.
So this is always my explanation to this. A lot of people see that and they say, oh, I could have done that. But you didn't do it, and that's why it's art.
No, I don't know that that's what makes it art. But it's easy to say you could have done it, sure. But that's just one barrier to entry.
A lot of people say my kid could have done that, but your kid didn't do it.
I know, I get that, but still, that doesn't make it art.
Well, could be. What? I don't understand the galleries who like, because the galleries are the ones who are responsible for determining whether or not they should have this, right?
That's exactly right.
So, like, who's the curator of this exhibit? Who's the first person who said, hey, that shovel you hung on the wall is art?
Exactly.
Why do we care, and why is it important?
Exactly. I mean, it doesn't matter whether or not your kid could or could not do whatever it is these artists did. What the artist did that your kid didn't do was he found a patron. And this is something that's existed for hundreds of years. You know, Michelangelo, Da Vinci, none of these guys are who they are unless they found a patron. And in many cases, some of these artists that we are so familiar with now over the years, their patron was the church. The success factor of any artist is who is willing to either A, pay you to do something, or B, display it so that somebody will buy it.
Right. And that comes back down to how do you value these kinds of things. And the value is how much is someone going to pay you for it.
Right. And that's entirely subjective. I mean, to answer your question, the museum curator decided to take some of Duchamp's work and put it into this display as a what? As a demonstration of how Marcel Duchamp challenged the idea of what art was. You know, he was trying to cause an emotional reaction, and he succeeded because I lost my fucking shit in the middle of the museum. I mean, that's probably why the curator did it. Why anybody would pay for that shit is an entirely different story.
So I've heard of this dude. I heard of Duchamp fairly recently. There's a podcast I listened to. It's a new one called A Piece of Work. It stars Abby Jacobson, I think her name is, the chick from Broad City.
Cool.
And so she has her bunch of her comedian friends. They come around with her, and they go to New York City, and they go around MoMA. And they kind of find different shit, and then she kind of is like, what do you think about this? So the first episode is Hannibal Buress and her walking around MoMA, and they go into a gallery with all this Duchamp shit. And there's like a wheel, like a bike wheel, not even with a tire, just a bike wheel with a fork on a stool. And that's art. It's in the middle of a floor. And then there's another one where there's just a shovel, like a metal shovel, like a snow shovel, hanging on the wall.
Yep, it's art. When you look at like a Monet painting, his style was pointillism. And he was able to take tiny brush strokes and take the colors and kind of fill in, like your eye fills in what the image is supposed to be by looking at all of the tiny brush strokes. So you can see the people hanging out on a riverbank. So you can appreciate the artistry in that. When you look at something like Sunflowers from Van Gogh, you can see some of the artistry in the brush strokes and stuff like that. I mean,
That shit is thick. That's one of the things you don't get to see a lot of times when you see that painting in like books and stuff, of how thick the paint is on the canvas.
Yeah. So, and you can appreciate that. I mean, when you look at some of these paintings from any of these artists, and you look at the shading and how they're drawing a scene of like, you know, waves crashing on the shore, crashing on these rocks, and you can see the spray of the water, and you can see the sun setting behind the water, and the reflection of the sun in the water. They're painting all of this from their mind's eye, right? I mean, the motion that's implied when you see the water hitting the rocks, that's not something that they can see. They're taking a snapshot of it in their head, and that's what they're painting. That's impressive. That's subjectively artful. You get that, and you have a urinal or a telephone next to a piece of shit or a felt jacket, I can't resolve the two. It just doesn't make any sense to me. Certainly not in the same building. If you took these different types of art, and I can't say whether or not a signed urinal is or is not art. In someone's head, it is. But put that where you can appreciate it amongst other things of its ilk.
I think I told you guys about the high school art project I helped my friend with.
No, I don't remember this.
It was an installation piece called Crab Lore.
Tell us this story. Please carry on.
Crab Lore was an alien intelligence that visited Earth, and that was his name, Crab Lore. And that was the art piece that my friend built, and it was this... It was kind of embedded into a mountainside. It was, you know, this artistic landscapey type thing, but it had a computer screen with which to interact with people. And my friend had me write a program to be, you know, Crab Lore. And Crab Lore liked to play games.
Like a bot?
Kind of like a... I mean, this was in the early 90s, and I used Pascal, so you can imagine how good it was.
It must have been awesome.
It was terrible. I was a terrible programmer then. So Crab Lore, he'd talk to people and, you know, through playing games. So you'd come up to the installation and you would play a game with Crab Lore. And I don't remember all of them, but one of them was, I think, Hangman. And that you had to guess what Crab Lore had for dinner. So it would play, you know, varying out that way. The problem was Crab Lore, if you didn't get it right, he would insult you.
That sounds about
stupid,
right.
Or you know, an idiot or a moron and things like that. Well, during the art show, children were excited by Crab Lore, and they wanted to play the Crab Lore game, and so they did. But when they saw Crab Lore's responses to their their incorrect guesses or moves or whatever, they got upset and started crying.
Nice.
To the point that the people running the show had to turn Crab Lore off.
Nice.
Making kids cry since 1985.
Good job, Ganthor. Making little kids cry. So what was the reaction to
would
that?
Hold on. Would you call that art?
No, I would not. I would call that an interactive exhibit.
Well, what is an interactive exhibit?
It's something that you can interact with. It's a exhibit that you can interact with. It's what I just said.
Well, so who gets to decide this?
That's, I think, the point. That's the whole point of all of this, is who gets to decide. And is there at all any objectivity to this? Because art is obviously a subjective thing. You know, art or beauty is in the eye of the beholder. And depending on what you're beholding, you can decide to call it whatever the heck you want.
And I've had some shits that I would call artful.
Well, there you go.
I came out of that and I'm like, yeah, I'd pay money to see that.
Right, so the real trick for that is to go find somebody who agrees with you and who's willing to put that in a gallery someplace.
That'd be amazing. Would you go to a gallery that just had shit on display?
Let me tell you something. If you managed to figure out how to get your shit on display, I would go.
You would see my opening day debut?
I would absolutely. Whatever Boston gallery there is that has your shit on display, I would come see it. Hands down, no question. So because I would want to meet the guy that decided that your shit was art.
My shit is bananas, but that's besides the point. The question is though, do you think the shit should be live or should it be a photograph?
There are plenty of people who do the live art presentations.
And that becomes, now you have the difference between is it art or is it porn or Shiza videos.
Right. So, I mean, if somebody, all right, here we go. If somebody is willing, this is the scam. This is what you got to do, Z. You got to find a guy who's willing to create an event where you come after, you know, eating a whole lot of Chipotle, come to the gallery, sit in front of everyone, drop trow, and sit on a throne in front of everyone, and take a shit.
I get performance anxiety.
You sit there, though.
All you gotta do is take a shit. You take a shit like three times a day.
I do, but I think I would get nervous.
Yeah, but what's that gonna do? Close up your sphincter?
Yeah, and then nothing's coming out.
Well, what if you just have to sit there?
Didn't they do that? Didn't they have a woman who did that, and then like, invited people to sit there and stare at her, and then there was another woman who did the same thing, like invited people to like cut clothes off of her.
Well, this was also what's that douchebag's name? Shia LaBeouf. He had that whole thing too, where he was just sitting there, and he would have people come in and like stare at him.
Yeah, because he's like, I'm not an actor anymore. I'm an artist,
right? Yeah,
he's trying to be all edgy.
This is what's considered performance art. So that's what you need to do. You need to find somebody, a patron, who's willing to put you on display to take a shit. It's performance art.
Right. And it would be super artistic, because I mean, like,
wait, what?
I'm just a naked fat dude taking a shit. Maybe I'll read the paper. I don't know.
Because and this is the artistic part of it. Nobody reads the paper anymore.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's a dig on media and society.
Yes.
And the lack of education.
Yes.
Of the middle class people. Yes. And the downfall of the paper industry.
Absolutely.
And mills.
So that's performance art. So you're.
All right. I got a friend who owns a gallery. Maybe see if she'll pick this up.
How about you, Ganthor? What would be your performance art?
Napping on a couch.
Yeah. I can see that. I think that's very interesting.
Yeah. You give it a dumbass arty name, and rich people spend a lot of money to watch that.
Yeah. Yeah. And it would be.
They might even buy the pillow that you drool on.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I don't know that I drool when I nap, but no,
you probably do.
But the pillow has to be like a silk screen of some, like, it's got to be like a picture of your dog or something. And it's got to be like, you can call it man's best friend. And you could be laying there on the couch asleep, drooling on the picture of the dog, which is what's usually drooling on you as the dog is sleeping on you. And you can say that this is a demonstration of how man and beast come together in order to have peace in their lives.
That's deep. Some deep shit right there.
That's what I'm talking about, man. I'll make this shit work. So, all right. So, so Z's going to take a shit and you're going to take a nap. What am I going to do?
Yeah, what are you going to do?
I don't know. I will be in a glass booth shouting obscenities as the people walk by.
Being angry, your normal angry self.
Being angry. This is not art. I am not art, you dopey motherfuckers. what is wrong with all of you? This is not art.
And I'll So up here we have a guy who goes around the city and he stencils not art on things, in which then becomes art.
How does that
Sounds
work?
Like a dick.
So like there's an old like gas station that has been abandoned for a while, and you know like how the gas station has those places we put the numbers for the price of the gas, like the leaded and unleaded and diesel or whatever. And it's like just those white squares. So he stencils in those white squares, not art. And then that's a thing. And they're like all over everything. It's like on the power boxes. It's on like – they're all over the city.
There's a guy somewhere in either like Finland or the Netherlands or something along those lines where he sees broken things out in the street and he paints – where he takes googly eyes and he puts them on. And then –
I've seen that. Or they do it with Legos.
Right. And then
it's
art.
Crack in the wall. Yeah.
Yeah, it's art. And then there was Banksy. Remember Banksy?
Banksy's awesome.
Right. Banksy would just run around doing random shit. Like,
so the crazy thing about Banksy is like, so he goes and paints a wall, right? He'll go and, you know, he'll get his stencils out. He paints some, you know, semi-political message on a wall. And if you're the owner of that wall, people will come and give you like hundreds and thousands of dollars if they can have that part of your wall.
Right.
Like they'll take all the bricks out, or if it's on a window, they want to take the window, and people will go nuts for this shit.
But how the fuck did that happen? Because somebody turned around and said, "Oh, this is a Banksy," like, and then it became like a noun, like a Banksy. It's a noun, right.
And so he came and spray painted a bunch of shit up here in Boston a while back, and he did two pieces, both on Essex Street, one in Cambridge and one in Chinatown, and the city just said, "Fuck it, it's not art, it's graffiti," and they sent out the city cleanup crews and they washed it all away.
There you go, Boston.
And everyone's like, "Are you fucking kidding me?" And yeah, they hosed it off. I watched him do it. It was insane.
They're not wrong. He's defacing property.
But that's like...
Dude, people paint murals all the time.
Yeah, but they have to get permits for that shit.
Have a permit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who did it belong to?
It was public property.
It was the side of a Supercuts.
I mean, I gotta give the city of Boston credit. Obviously, there's nobody in the city of Boston that's artistic. They turned around and they said, "That's not art. That's fucking graffiti. We got to clean that shit up."
What do you call it when you commission? I wish I had enough stupid money that I could just commission people to do whatever the fuck I want.
I would take a
what
shit.
What would
for
you commission? We know what Spear would commission. You taking a shit.
Yeah,
what would you commission?
Hey, I'm willing to commission you taking a nap too, so don't throw stones.
I mean, obviously, there's going to be a crushed velvet painting of me. most like with a shotgun and a couple hounds.
What you need, what you need is like dogs playing poker, and then you're at the table with the dogs.
Am I the dealer?
You could be. You could be. You could be playing with the dogs.
That would be interesting.
Yeah, I mean,
either one of those variants, but
I'd make a whole gallery of just like me.
The Z gallery.
The Z gallery Z.
Gallery Z. I like that. It sounds
just
trendy.
Staring at you, creeping you out.
It sounds trendy.
Have and just when you thought you were out of the room, there'd be another one just staring back at you again.
and then as you come around the corner, there's the actual Z just staring at you.
Yeah, and people think by that point they're probably just going to punch me in the face.
So maybe not you. Maybe like a wax statue of you, perhaps. That's what I would do. I would have commissioned a wax statue of me in a seated position, and then I would roll it into a conference room where I'm supposed to be in a meeting. And then I would just leave it in the room and then go so that I could be
anatomically correct.
Yeah, all of it anatomically correct. And then I would just leave it there in the room and then go do whatever the hell I want instead of having to attend the meeting.
I don't know. I wouldn't waste it in a meeting room. I mean, unless it was your own company.
What would you do?
I'd probably commission a movie.
A movie of what?
I like tragic stuff. Tragic romantic stuff, not like Romeo and Juliet, but kind of like the original Little Mermaid.
Book, with the Little Mermaid again.
Responsible for traumatizing me, I think, to this day.
Always with the fish and the cloaca thing, man.
Yeah, it is. I mean, maybe that's what's wrong with me.
So what I think you should commission then is a mermaid statue complete with working cloaca.
Well, now you're just making it lewd.
Why?
What purpose would a working cloaca serve except for some deviant to try and have sex with it?
Yes.
And by deviant, you mean yourself?
Yeah. I'm trying to help you out here, Ganthor.
Well, no, is it in the privacy of my own home, or is it in a public park, like in a square, like Trafalgar Square?
Well, I would consider it a gallery piece for starters. And if you wanted to turn it into performance art where you're actively banging the cloaca, then I think you could do that too.
I would have performance anxiety.
The two of you with it, but performance anxiety. Dude, we would get you drunk and full of Viagra, and you would just bang the shit out of that thing. It would be no problem. Yeah, I'd play Kiss the Girl in the back. It would be the whole thing.
I want to be part of your world.
There you go.
You could have me come sing with you.
Now we're talking. Now it's the whole thing comes together.
You make me hard.
Okay. What did we learn? What did we learn about art, about the subjectivity of art, about commissioning, patronage? What did we learn, Z-Man?
People will pay to watch me take a shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe.
We got to find somebody who's willing to do it. Ganthor, what'd you learn?
That you have terrible taste.
It's not about having terrible taste, Ganthor.
I'm just telling you what I learned, dude.
Okay. All right. I learned that I have a difficult time discerning between what is art and what is a fucking porcelain urinal with someone's chicken scrawl on it, because I can't figure that the fuck out.
Are you just jealous that you didn't think of it first?
Probably. That's probably my biggest problem, is that somebody else got there before I did. I just have to figure out a way to do it. So if you want to put a urinal up on a pedestal and call it art, or a felt suit, or a chunk of shit, or if you would pay to watch Z-Man take a dump or Ganthor take a nap, why don't you go ahead and let us know on the Facebook page, facebook.com/4listeners or 4listeners.com. I think we should do this. I think we should get a patron who will commission us.
Get a GoFundMe page?
Right? And, I mean, we need to have Ganthor with the mermaid statue banging it in the cloaca while you're singing Kiss the Girl. I mean, to me, that's performance art of the highest quality. We need to work that out. Check out the show on Stitcher Radio, on Apple Podcasts, or on Google Play. Just search for 4listeners. We'll pop right on up, and you can give us a tweet on the Twitters at 4listeners. We thank you for checking us out this week, and we hope that you will check us out again next week. Thanks a bunch, everybody. Wandering free, wish I could be part of that world. Like I have a hard time trying to resolve all of that in my head, that there are these things that are hundreds of years old, millennia in some cases, and then, you know, the stuff that you find at a consignment store. Like, how do those two things exist in the same building?
I don't know. I was in Bruges last week, and I got to touch the blood of Christ.
What?
There's a church that claims to have a vessel that contains the blood of Christ.
Are you immortal now?
I don't know. I thought I was just going to catch on fire because I'm Jewish.
Oh, shit, that's right.